little bit about the timing of your visit here, the significance of it.
Well, I think it's a very important time for me to be here, for FIFA to be here, FIFA President, together with Victor Montagliani, FIFA Vice President, CONCACAF President, to see our dear friend Alfredo, what he's up to in Cayman Islands in football development. It's important because it comes at an important period for football in Cayman Islands. We have been able to witness the work that is done here by Alfredo after his election. We all know the situation as it was, and we are very encouraged of the situation as it is. And that's why this visit here, this trip here to Cayman Islands is really meant to be an encouragement to Alfredo, to his team, to CIFA, but to the whole community, to the football community of Cayman Islands, but to the community more generally. Football is more than just a sport, right? It's a school of life, it's education, it's fair play, it's respect, it's a lot of these values that maybe got lost, or even if maybe got lost in some parts of the world in the past, and that we have to rebuild, and that we have to show to the people that we are rebuilding. And I think this is what is happening. We have football people, we have Alfredo who is a football person who is doing that, and we are here to encourage that. We are coming immediately after the Women's World Cup, for example, which was extremely successful. It's, as a matter of fact, also my first official visit in this part of the world after the Women's World Cup, and I'm happy that I'm coming here to Cayman to show and to give really a sign and a signal that we are working together to rebuild really the football from the basis, from the boys, from the girls, and again, very, very happy of what I see, and sure we can build on it. Well, we've been discussing today mainly about the projects that have been put in place and are put in place by CIFA with regard to boys and girls football, youth football. In particular, we've been seeing girls playing, for example, today in the tournament, but this is only part of a wider movement with much more regular games, more competitions, more players, more referees, boys, girls, under 11, under 14, and so on and so forth, to really make sure that the whole community of Cayman Islands is involved in football. And this is very important, and these projects are very important. Of course, in addition to that, we have been, but this is already part of our work in the past, we have been looking at the situation, the financial situation, because we don't have to hide these topics as well, of CIFA, and you know, we all know that CIFA was under restricted funding, and still is for the time being, but the news are very positive in this respect, and we are looking at building with the new funds which are there from FIFA, the forward funds, the infrastructure which is also needed, in particular also here next door, right, to give even more opportunities to play football for the whole community.
So you're confirming that funding is coming back? Is there a set date?
Well, it's not my decision, it's a decision of the Audit and Compliance Committee that is gathering in the next couple of weeks. And as it looks like, the situation is very positive. There is there are still some checks going on, of course, but it looks very positive.
So from your standpoint, if it was a decision for you to make, would you be giving the thumbs up?
I will always give the thumbs up for every decision which involves investment in football and infrastructure. Obviously, as I was saying before, I mean, you know, we cannot change the past, right? The past is the past, and the past situation, in particular in Cayman Islands, football is affecting or has affected the present. And that's why the work which was done here by Alfredo and his team has been probably even, or we followed probably, but certainly harder than in many, many other places. I know what I'm speaking about because the situation I found FIFA in when I arrived a couple of years ago was also not really the best one. And you know, you have to roll up your sleeves and you have to work. And that's exactly what has happened here. So this has been done in a very short time frame. And now, again, from my side, whatever help and assistance we can give, it's not about financial assistance, it's about football assistance. The financial assistance are there, and it depends on the different criteria that we have set that are the same all over the world. But in terms of support and encouragement, well, together with CONCACAF, we are here, and the fact we are visiting and we are here present in person, I think it's really the signal that from our side, thumbs up and let's continue to work. The situation, my wish and my hope as FIFA president with my delegation was simply to come here to say hello, to say look at what we are doing, at how much we are investing now in football. Don't forget that FIFA has multiplied by 5 the investments in football development in every country. So now it's $1.5 million a year, which will be invested in football development, infrastructure, organization. And this is done auditing fully, and this is also a difference to the past, auditing fully everything that happens with that money. This was not the case in the past. This is the case in the present. My wish was, of course, to convey this message as well to the authorities, to say, well, this is a new FIFA, this is a new CONCACAF, this is a new organization of football as well in Cayman Island. And we want to work all together because finally our mission, as well as the mission of the government, is to work for the society, for the children, for the boys, for the girls. I mean, the point of view, we have the same mission. I don't think it is realistic to believe that in the very near future, Cayman Island national team will become world champion. So the mission is not necessarily to build the team of world champions of football, boys or girls or men or women, but it is to work indeed for the society. The World Cup will be to have 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 10 or 100 children off the street playing football. And to do this in the right way, we need to work together. We offer our hand, we offer our help to the authorities, and the fact the meetings didn't materialize today are sad, but we are here and we will continue to help and come back whenever necessary to do something again for our people, people of Cayman Island.
From CONCACAF's perspective, what's it mean to turn the page on the recent past and to welcome Cayman back into good graces, if that's not the bad way to phrase it?
Yeah, listen, from a CONCACAF perspective, I don't think we just turned the page. I think the book was thrown away. We've written a new book. I was here not too long ago. We had a summit here, a leadership summit. You know, the facts are the facts. The facts are that this administration, led by Alfredo and his team, have worked their butts off, and you can see the results. Not only they're doing it for Cayman, they're doing it for CONCACAF. I mean, they're hosting a Nations League game here with 2 other countries in September. That shows not only he's doing it for Cayman football, he's doing it for CONCACAF football, and that shows the spirit of the organization, why you have the right people here that are going to push the game forward, because they know it's about the community, they know it's about football. So, you know, I already knew what was here, because as I said before, Alfredo has my full confidence. He's a soldier, he's a leader, and for me it's very important that FIFA came and saw, and I'm happy that my president came and saw exactly the work that's been done here and the work that will continue to be done here with our support. So I think the people that will benefit from it are obviously the young girls that we saw this morning, the U-14s who are playing St. Lucia tonight, And I think I see nothing but positive things for Cayman football.